Baltimore Transport Secretary June Abaya and other officials are cleared of graft charges over the allegedly anomalous MRT3 maintenance contract with a Filipino-Korean firm during the Aquino administration. Let's get more details on that from our correspondent, Adrian Ayalin. Adrian, what else can you tell us?
Yes, Hermina, the Office of the Ombudsman has dismissed the graft and plunder complaints against former Department of Transportation and Communications Secretary Joseph Emilio Abaya over the $4.2 billion MRT3 long-term maintenance contract of the government with Busan Joint Venture and Busan Universal Rail Incorporated, or BURI. In a resolution dated January 31, 2019, the Ombudsman likewise cleared public and private respondents Edwin Lopez, René Rincauco, Catherine Jennifer Francis Gonzalez, Roman Buenafe, Camille Alcaraz, Ofelia Astrera, Charisa Eloisa Julia Opulencia, Oscar Bongon, Jose Rodante Sabayle, Eldon Ferdinand Uy Elizabeth Velasco, Belinda Ong Tan, Brian Velasco, Antonio Borromeo, Junho Huang, and Elpidio Silvestre Uy. The resolution of the special panel headed by Deputy Special Prosecutor Omar Sagadal was approved by Ombudsman Samuel Martirez on November 9, 2020. The Ombudsman stressed in the resolution that the problems which hounded the MRT3 railway operations appeared to be in the implementation stage, which involved issues not present during the screening, negotiation, and bidding processes. It was also noted that based on records, the Busan JV and the BURI corporations had already been penalized for the problems that cropped up in the implementation of the project through deductions in their payments and the subsequent pre-termination of the contract. The MRTC maintenance contract entered into by the Aquino administration in 2016 was terminated by the Duterte government in 2017. The graft complaint against Abaya and other individuals was filed by Bagong Alyansang Makabayan, while the plunder complaint was filed by officials of the current Department of Transportation, both in 2017. In 2018, former Ombudsman Conchita Harpio Morales issued a resolution finding probable cause to file one count of graft against Abaya and the other respondents before the Sandigan Bayan. In the same resolution, Morales dismissed the charges against other Aquino officials and private respondents, including Mar Rojas, Florencio Abad, Cesar Purisima. Motions for reconsideration were then filed by Abaya and the other respondents. Abaya said in his appeal that he had no supervision nor control over the bids and awards committee, and there was no conspiracy to ensure the award of the contract to Busan JV. The DOTR also insisted on the presence of the elements of plunder, noting that Rojas and Abaya were identified as the main plunderers. In the resolution approved by Martirez, the dismissal of the charges against Rojas and other respondents ordered by Morales was upheld. Bayan Secretary General Renato Reyes expressed disappointment in a Facebook post, noting the irony that Ombudsman Carpio Morales, an Aquino appointee, indicted Aquino's former DOTC officials, and Ombudsman Martirez, a Duterte appointee, dismissed the complaint. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Our correspondent there, Adrian Ayalin.